So the answer is 1/7, which is pretty good. There aren't many things that we deal with where we can think of them in terms of fractions of the speed of light and fractions above 10%. So our data was traveling between California and Massachusetts at a speed of about 43,000 kilometers per second. And most of that time is not the time on the wire. While the data is traveling on the wires, it's traveling pretty close to the speed of light. The speed of light through optical fiber is about 50% slower than light travels in a vacuum. But what's taking up most of the time is all the routers that it had to go through. And we saw that from the trace route that it went through about 20 routers. So each of those routers had to take a packet in, figure out where to send it, and do all that in the time that it had to travel across the country, which was 100 milliseconds total. So the average speed going across the country was 1/7 the speed of light. I can show you the Python code to compute that. So we have the distance, which is 4,300. That's the number of kilometers between Palo Alto and Cambridge. We have the speed of light, which is approximately 300,000 kilometers per second. And we have the time it took, which, since we're using seconds as our unit for the speed of light, we should put in seconds. And so it was 100 milliseconds, which is 0.1 seconds. And so I can compute the time it took light to travel that distance by dividing the distance by the speed of light. And let's see what that is. So if it was traveling at the speed of light, it would take 0.014 seconds to get across the country, which is 14 milliseconds. What it actually took was 100 milliseconds. And if we divide the time it actually took by the time it would take light to travel, we get 6.97. So it's taking almost seven times as long as it would take if it was just light traveling in a vacuum for that distance. If you had a vacuum between Palo Alto and Cambridge and no routers and nothing else along the way, well, then you could get your packets across about seven times faster than the internet actually does. Not many people can afford setting up a dedicated vacuum between the two points they want to communicate.